So at the start of the year, whether I'm teaching a ninth grade class of incoming high school students or a senior class about to apply to college, what I do is I ask them to draw a metaphor of themselves as a writer and a metaphor of themselves as a reader. So what that activity does right away is a few things. One, it asks them to contend with this concept called metaphor, right? And students, particularly ninth grade students, come into my class assuming that they know what metaphors are, right? It's a comparison that does not use like or as. That's their working definition. And what I say to them is, while that is technically correct, the way that I also want them to think about metaphor is that it impacts the way that we move through the world and think about our possibility in it. And they kind of look at me quizzically, right? But then what we do is they spend some time drawing a picture that represents for them what it's like to be a writer. And then they draw a picture that represents what it is for them to be a reader. And for some of them, if reading and writing are difficult, they draw themselves climbing these really steep mountains, barely making it to the top or not even being able to see the top. If it's something that they enjoy, that they gravitate to intrinsically, then what they do is they will draw themselves maybe on a hammock or swimming at the beach, right? Something that speaks to their feeling about what it is to do that activity and what they imagine is possible for them. I actually had one student this year draw themselves at the top of the triad for an Olympic event where they get their medals, and they were wearing a gold medal because that's how they feel when they read. They feel like champions. So collecting that information and having the students from day one, before I instruct them in anything at all, lets me know what their prior knowledge about themselves is as learners, right? What are their preconceived notions about what is possible for them? And then what we do is we look at a few metaphors that are sort of stock metaphors in our cultural context. So one example might be the light bulb moment, right? Everyone is pretty much familiar with this idea that thinking is often imagined as a light bulb coming on, that great idea, right? But then I talked through that idea with my students, and they come to understand that if they think, if they go through the world, if they go through school, imagining that good thinkers have light bulb moments all the time, as opposed to thinking that learning and having good ideas is actually an iterative process, that it takes time, it takes effort, it takes thoughtfulness and deliberate attention to what you're doing, then they're going to think that those kids who seem to have quote-unquote light bulb moments all the time, can answer a question right away, are the smart ones, and that they are ineffective learners. And so we break down that metaphor, and I show them that if we walk through the world with one concept, then it actually limits what's possible to us. But if we open up our minds to other kinds of concepts, other kinds of metaphors, like electrical circuits possibly, right, traveling to each other in order to create that light bulb moment, then they have a better sense of possibility for them in this class in ways that they don't come in with in the beginning.